Give us a prioritize, say yes, I care. Fake yourself, right? Is yours? Hey, is yours as sexy as you care? I was rescued. Gee, sure is a safety answer because I was faster. In order to proceed, please vote to re-elect District Attorney Todd Fisher for my family and yours. Gee, sure is a safety answer because I was faster. Gee, boss of my heart, I was safety answer because
discerning drivers will appreciate the 2011 Land Rover Range Rover. A 5-liter V8 engine pairs with a sophisticated 6-speed automatic transmission, providing a smooth and predictable driving experience. 4-wheel drive allows you to go places you've only imagined.
Each and every detail of the exterior expresses muscularity. This vehicle achieves a sporty stance when viewed from all angles. You can rely on ultra-bright xenon headlights to keep the roadway illuminated. Underbody vehicle components are protected by the skid plates, allowing this vehicle to overcome difficult off-road terrain.
The interior of this vehicle is nothing short of spectacular, treating occupant comfort with paramount concern. All of the following features are included: one-touch window functionality, rain-sensing wipers, and seat memory.
Enjoy your favorite music via the stereo system, which includes a CD player with MP3 capability and 14 speakers, yielding maximum audio versatility. Passengers are protected by various safety and security features, including traction control, anti-whiplash front head restraints, and 4-wheel disc brakes with ABS.
The 2011 Land Rover Range Rover. Distinctly rendered with the utmost precision, this SUV lines up eagerly against competing models, delivering the perfect blend of power, safety, and flair.
Hosting the summit, right? And this is a guy who myself on some familiarity with Latin America. I mean, he was actually the Latin America expert for the last 40 years. But here's what's going on. You've got all these governments now turning away from democracy. The rule of law is gone. And with that, we're certainly less than not prior tradition disengaged from the U.S. You know, just said no. Mexico's president, Andres Manuel López Obrador, he's not attending. No, thank you. I'm not coming. Why? Well, because you, the United States, are not inviting Cuba, Venezuela, or Nicaragua. So what happens next? Bolivia says it's not coming. And there's still some Central American countries that are still on the fence. And this has to do with the influence of the United States in Latin America. It's heading south. Because, again, polarization. Here, there, I mean, it doesn't stop. Even at the point now where the Biden administration has downplayed expectations. And has said, it really doesn't matter if some countries are dangerous. It's still an important topic. No, it really isn't. It's not even nearly as important. It used to be almost your point of being irrelevant. Here's one reason, or a couple reasons. Number one, 1994 was something that was really important. They had 9/11. Boy, did that change our view. All we cared about was terrorism, and it all went to the Middle East. Our attention, fair enough. Then you had a player by the name of China come in. We used to be the only game in town. China comes in and starts just unloading tons of money into Latin America. These incredible loans with strings attached. Disengage from the United States, get closer to us. Now, is it complete? Of course not. But it has certainly changed the dynamics around. And so as you look at this site here in Los Angeles, I don't even really talk about it because it's LA-based. Otherwise, I don't even know, because these summits don't mean a lot. I mean, on a personal level, well, here was a hugely successful summit. Oh, how about President Trump and Kim Jong-un? That was a successful one. Remember when President Trump said, I'm glad. I don't know, I got that wrong, didn't I? He's okay, I call him Vlad. He did say that it's a beautiful friendship. And that Kim wrote a beautiful letter. By the way, did you ever see a picture of that letter down below? Yeah, take a look at him delivering or Trump receiving an envelope with a personal letter in it. It is massive. Well, you know, you've seen those oversized birthday cards?
Yeah.
That was the size of the envelope. Then the letter is in. Yeah, very strange. I mean, just the whole thing.
Okay.
So much for that. All right, I'm going to go back to water use now in rural communities. Big cities, we're in trouble, but man, not even close to rural communities when it comes to the use of water, the allocation of water. I'll come up with that. That's coming up.
That's really good.
Live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom.
Several big decisions are expected from the U.S. Supreme Court the next few days. The Justice States will issue opinions on Roe v. Wade, religious freedoms, immigration, climate change, and a person's right to carry a gun in public. The U.S. Navy's detained a pilot who was killed when a fighter jet crashed in the Mojave Desert. Lieutenant Richard Bullock went down in a remote area in San Bernardino County Friday during a routine training mission.
Cha-cha-cha.
Traffic Center, let's go, Clinton.
Yeah. Camaro.
So we've got these water pipes.